All right, David here with another video, and today we are going to be talking about wheels that I think are good for surf skate hybrids. So I think the two most popular surf skate hybrids on the market are the Carver C5 and Yao Legacy. I own both of these trucks and I've ridden on both sets of wheels that come stock on these setups, and I really was not impressed by them. The urethane didn't feel high quality and they felt very slow. So here I'm going to talk about a couple wheels that I think work really well for surf skate hybrids like Carver C5 and Yao Legacy. But whether or not the wheels in this review video are going to be right for you depends on your skate park, how stiff or loose your setup is ridden, and your riding style. So we'll start with the Andy Anderson Nano Cubics. The specs on these wheels are: they are a 60 mm diameter, 97A durometer, 38 mm wide, 21.5 mm contact patch. These wheels weigh 361 grams. The bearing seat is side set and they have an asymmetrical shape. For color options, you're just going to get white with blue font. And the size range on these is 52 to 60 mm. And these are priced on their website at $48.95. So how do these wheels roll? Fantastic. Even though these wheels have a mere 21.5 mm contact patch, this wheel was formulated to be a harder wheel that would handle rougher ground better, and it does just that. This wheel rolls fast and feels great on both smooth, polished skate parks and my local skate park, which has somewhat rougher concrete. It also absorbs impact from ollie-based maneuvers and flyouts decently well. I didn't think this wheel was very suitable for the local asphalt pump track because it wasn't very fast or smooth. So I would recommend this wheel for smooth to mildly rough concrete surfaces only. How do these wheels pump? Decently well. I set up my Carver C5 with 90 to 95A bushings, and I don't do a lot of deep carving on my Carver C5. But I can confidently pump to maintain speed and carve moderately deep. However, if you ride your setup with looser, softer bushings for deep carving and aggressive pumping, you will probably slide out accidentally because these wheels will lose traction. How do these wheels slide? This wheel slides perfectly fine. If I had to describe the slide feel, I would say it acts like a harder wheel, but has a soft feel to it. These wheels actually felt so soft and comfortable when I was riding them that when I went to do these first slides, I leaned back quite a bit because I didn't think they would slide well. But they slid better than I expected, and I found this wheel had a smooth, intuitive slide that was easy to control. Again, me slipping and falling backwards was just because I leaned back too far, thinking these wheels wouldn't slide very well. But once I got used to how these wheels slid, I felt very confident controlling the slide, even on these revert tricks. So what makes this wheel special? The first reason I sought this wheel in particular is that asymmetrical side set shape. The Carver C5 hanger is pretty narrow for my liking at 5.75 inches or 146 millimeters, and by putting a wheel on that is totally side set, it essentially makes the Carver C5 hanger wider. This makes my Carver C5 more suitable for wider decks and creates more hanger space for grinding. The inside of this wheel is flat and squared off, and I find this does help me lock in the grinds more easily than wheels that are rounded on the inside. The outside of the wheel is super rounded, which is supposed to help with wall rides and slappy grinds. This wheel is very lightweight at only 361 grams in the 60 mm size. You have options for smaller sizes also because they make these between 52 and 60 millimeters. And again, this wheel has a smooth, intuitive slide initiation and a very nice break-in traction. So this is a high-quality formula from Powell, which is owned by Skate One, and Skate One also owns Bones wheels. On my friend's skateboard, I had ridden the Bones X97 wheels, and I thought that these wheels felt exactly the same. So I reached out to Skate One, and I asked them if the 97A Nano Cubic formula was the same formula they used for the Bones X97. They responded back and they said that it is, quote, almost the same formula with a small variance to allow for brand differentiation. So they're basically the same formula. I bring this up because Powell doesn't make a lot of different shapes in this amazing formula they use for the nanocubics. So if you wanted more options for wheel shapes in this urethane that I think works really well, look into the Bones X97 as well as their harder version, the X99.
So the last thing I want to address about the nanocubics is the 93A Powell Peralta Dragon nanocubic. So I actually bought the 93A nanocubic first, and I rode this one for a good while. And I got curious and I wanted to try out the 97A. And so here's my quick take on the general difference. Both of these actually slide about the same. Prior to trying out both nanocubics, I originally thought that the 93A was going to be grippier because it is a softer wheel. However, like I said in a previous Powell Dragon review video, this 93A formula is a wheel that is meant to slide like a 99A. So this 93A is very slidey for how soft it is. So given that the grip is roughly the same, why would you choose one of these wheels over the other? Well, the 97A, I think, is significantly faster than the 93A Powell Dragon. I would say that the 93A nanocubic does better on rougher ground and smooths out vibrations better than the 97A nanocubic. But if you're riding smooth to mildly rough concrete surfaces, such as those found in skate parks, I honestly think you're going to be happier with the increased speed that the 97A nanocubic has to offer. I find that the 97A nanocubic grips just as well and performs similarly in skate parks as the 93A. It just rolls faster because it's a bit harder. And so this brings us to the Powell Dragon 60x42 wheel. So I made a full review of this Powell Dragon 60x42, and I talk about how it is a side set asymmetrical shape, much like the nanocubics. The primary difference is that these nanocubics only offer about a 21 or 22 millimeter contact patch, whereas this Powell Dragon 60x42 offers a 30 millimeter contact patch, making this the grippiest of all three. And so my suggestion is that if you're someone who likes the Powell 93A nanocubic, is that you either upgrade to the 97A and you're going to get an increase in speed, or you upgrade to the Powell Dragon 60x42 and you're going to get more grip. Because to me personally, this 93A Powell nanocubic just isn't doing anything that the other two wheels are not doing.
Another wheel I've been riding on my Carver C5 is my Spitfire Soft Sliders. There's several shapes and sizes, and I own the largest one that they make right now, which is their 58mm radial shape. So the specs are 58mm diameter, 93A durometer, 38mm wide, 25mm contact patch, and these wheels weigh 329 grams. So believe me when I say, from lots of experience riding these, that these wheels feel much harder than the 93A Powell Dragon wheels. They even feel a little bit harder than the 97A Andy Anderson nanocubic. These 93A wheels even have an extra 3.5mm contact patch compared to the nanocubics, which should make the ride feel a bit smoother, but I definitely find these wheels feel a little bit harder than those 97A nanocubics. But I really like this wheel for what it is, so let's get into what it does well. So how does it roll? It rolls really nice. Even though this wheel feels pretty hard, it performs really well on smooth to mildly rough concrete. I recommend this wheel for both mildly rough surfaces like my nearby skate park and polished surfaces. It smooths out vibrations pretty well, but again, I would stay away from asphalt on these. So how do they pump? Good enough for a surfskate hybrid. You wouldn't want these on your traditional surfskate, but these wheels have a little extra grip relative to how hard they feel that hold on pretty decently for pumping and carving. So how do these wheels slide? This wheel has more of a hard wheel slide. Softer wheels like Powell Dragons have a softer slide that's quiet and more smooth. This Spitfire Soft Slider has more of a hard wheel slide. It has that distinct hard wheel barking sound, and it feels more icy, but it's an intuitive, easy to control slide. And this wheel does feel like a harder wheel slide than the 97A nanocubics. So what makes this wheel special? This wheel is the lightest wheel on the list of wheels that I am making a review for. being a lightweight wheel is going to make ollie-based tricks feel lighter, and it's also a very nice high-quality feeling urethane. I also like that this wheel is center set. I know I frequently talk about how I personally like side set wheels for more hanger space, but there are advantages to a center set wheel that I and other people can appreciate. Being center set and moving wheels towards the center of the board makes flipping the board and rotating the board easier, so that means more conducive for kickflips, shove-its, etc. I find that this wheel feels very nice on ledges and rails for doing grinds and slides. So when I'm in the mood for more of a street plaza type session, these 58mm Spitfire radial soft sliders have been perfectly satisfying for me. So my final thoughts on Surfskate hybrid wheels is I would highly recommend the 97A Nano Cubics from Powell. I would also recommend the Bones X Formula 97 or X99 because those are comparable to the Nano Cubic formula. And I would also recommend the Spitfire soft sliders. For me personally, I like the side set 97A Nano Cubics for bull riding because they open up my hanger more and they have that lock-in profile making grind tricks easier. And that side set shape provides a little bit more stability, making me feel more comfortable going higher speeds. Alternatively, I prefer the center set Spitfire Radial 93A for more street and plaza style riding because I like the slide and it feels more nimble and less stable than the Nano Cubics, making ollies, flip tricks, shove-its, grind tricks more intuitive. There's loads of other wheels out there by companies like Richta and OJ that could probably be good, but I just haven't tried them. So for my Surfskate hybrids, I'm probably going to be sticking to the Bones, Powell, and Spitfires that I mentioned in this video. The urethanes and formulas are so good, and these wheels are pretty affordable. They're all between $40 and $50. I hope you found this video helpful, and I'll see you in the next one.